We'll get started here. So hi everyone, my name is Karan Rao. Thank you all for taking the time today for this discussion, right? As you can see, we're going to talk about how e-commerce companies are cutting costs by automating image and video creation, right? So my role at Rocketium, and we're going to talk a little bit about what Rocketium does, but my role essentially involves working with large enterprises and trying to solve unique creative challenges at that, right? So let's jump right in. So for some context here, right? So we know that COVID has had certain impact on businesses, right? Some of the intuitive ones are, you know, revenue is being hit substantially. Everyone is focusing on optimizing costs, like every item on your income statement is being looked at. And obviously companies are also forced to freeze hiring and in some unfortunate situations also consider layoffs, right? But what is interesting is some of these challenges, how they are transcending to the creative ecosystem, right? And when I say creative ecosystem, I mean anyone who's either making creatives or using them or also enabling them, right? So the first one is obviously the creative team is typically considered a cost center. So as you can imagine, there are a lot of efficiency and cost targets and reduction of costs at play here. Any kind of external spends, both on technology and human resources, are being curtailed, right? And that only means that the internal teams or the existing teams are burdened with making sure that a larger amount of output is maintained, right? And also in these uncertain times, as we are trying different types of experiments, especially to spur revenue, there is a lot of pressure on these creative teams to quickly turn around visuals for these experiments, right? So with that in mind, today we are going to talk about how we have worked with some of our clients, right, especially in the e-commerce space, and how they are using automation to reduce their creative costs, right? So before we jump into that, I just want to lay down some context. I can see that we do have some of our customers on the call, but for those who don't know about us, so Rocketium essentially is a creative automation platform, right? When I say creative, we do images, videos, GIFs. When I say automation, again, our platform enables different kinds of automation use cases. So typically, we would work with a customer, understand what sort of creative challenges they are facing, and then bringing together solutions that actually help optimize their design or creative workflow, right? So how do we help companies, right? So firstly, we help internal teams. So when I say internal teams, this could be marketing teams, sales teams, and we enable a nice interface for them to automatically generate creatives, which would have taken them a long time to do. So we're going to talk a little bit about how we do that, right? We empower external partners, right? Case in point with Amazon, how we are enabling using our white label solutions and enabling external partners, vendors to create videos for our clients, right? Videos and images. And lastly, we are going to talk about how without any human intervention, using our APIs, we are able to generate videos and images programmatically, right? So let's get right to it. We're going to follow the same theme throughout the presentation. So we will go ahead and start with enabling internal teams, right? So typically in an e-commerce setup, you have a central design team which caters to the requests of the merchandise of different functional teams, right? So you can think of the merchandising team, marketing teams, and it could be other business functions as well, right? And typically these design teams are overburdened with they're bogged down with a lot of creative requests. And just imagine if an e-commerce company has 1,000, 10,000 products, they have to every month keep creating banners over and over again. And that leads to redundant non-creative work, right? And not only that, they have to create the same banner in multiple orientations because these banners either go on apps, on the website, on social platforms, etc., right? So there's a lot of redundant work, which is typically not creative. It's just continuously repeating the same outputs over and over again, right? The second point is they also have to ensure that each output meets brand standards, right? They're churning out so many outputs, but not even one output can misalign, or it cannot, somewhere they need to make sure that the output actually aligns with the brand standards and guidelines, which are very clearly set by the brand team, right? So they need to be, they need to guard the brand standards, right? And finally, just because there are these multiple requests, the turnaround times are really long because communication channels are not very linear. And typically they look like this, right? Because there are multiple, there is a lot of back and forth between the business teams, design team, especially as you go towards closer towards the sale time. There are a lot of last minute changes, and all of this causes a lot of effort or a lot of stress on the design team, right? So how do we help them? We actually sit in the middle. One of our products, which I'm going to talk about, sits in the middle. And what it does is tries to remove a lot of the redundant work for design teams. And at the same time, we enable self-service creation for the different business teams without them having to know a lot of, they don't need a lot of skills to actually make these creatives, right? So how do we do that? We do that with a product called Campaign, right? So if you are seeing my screen, this has a very simple interface wherein you come in and you will see these bunch of templates, right? So let me talk to you a little bit about templates. So templates are essentially, in the word, in terms of Rocketeam, are a mold or a structure which have certain design and layout rules, right? Now, these templates can be completely customized for, you know, a particular client. So typically, we would work with our clients, we would make templates for them. We also have a product where they themselves can create the templates, right? So end-to-end self-service. For image templates, we actually have a PSD plugin. So you click a button, your Photoshop file becomes a template. And we are also able to, if you think about video templates, import information from an advanced software like After Effects so that your end output can look really complex and aesthetic, right? Now, once these templates are set up, what you're essentially doing is somewhere laying down your brand rules and guidelines through these templates, right? Now, once these templates are set up, let's say a business user, let's say someone from a performance marketing team is using it. They you know, click a template. Now they're able to choose from sizes, right? So each template can be set up in how many ever sizes. So I remember once one of our client was actually creating 60 different variations. So every template of theirs had 60 variations and they were able to create it all in one shot, right? So you would come here, you can set up the sizes based on the standard sizes that you have on different social platforms. If you have any custom sizes for your app or for your website, all of them can be set up for each template, right? So once these templates are, once the template is chosen, you choose the sizes that you want to make, you land on an interface like this, right? So a very intuitive, simple interface. On the right-hand side, you have all the content that you can add. So you can upload the images, logo, any kind of captions, however the template is set up and whatever variables we've identified in the template, right? And on the right, you will be able to see the preview. And this preview will be real-time for both a video and an image, right? So somewhere we want to make this more a content entry experience rather than a styling experience, right? And how do we do that? We do that by making sure that our templates are really, really smart, right? So just to give you a few examples. So the first cool part is when you're typing a caption and a template is already set up, we can ensure that the caption self-adjusts in the font so that the end creative looks aesthetic, right? Yeah, the text is not wrapping, it's not overlapping with something else. It's looking nice and aesthetic in that layout, right? One other example of this is, imagine your creative has multiple captions. Let's say for one of these creatives, you don't want a caption. Typically in a tool like Photoshop, there would be negative space. You would have to adjust it, make sure it's all spaced out. But in this case, the layout automatically adjusts to account for whatever information is not there. Again, the goal is that the output should look aesthetic. I shouldn't be spending a lot of time styling this creative, right? And finally, this is something we've spoken about, but just having auto adapts, right? Within a click, being able to create all these different variations without having to do this manually one after the other, right? So for that one client that I spoke about, they used to just add information once and they used to have 60 various versions of that banner created that then could be pushed on different channels, right? And finally, one of the features that is really popular with our customers is our spreadsheet upload feature, right? So in the same interface, what you can do is, let's say you have a spreadsheet worth of information where, let's say you have 500 products, you have the name of the product, the price of the product, a URL of the image, you could just go ahead and upload it. You would have 500 rows worth of information fed in within a minute. And not only that, if you had, let's say, even three orientations of each variant created, you would have 500 into 1500 banners created in literally a minute, right? So this is something that a lot of our e-commerce customers use, primarily because they have a lot of structured data, which potentially they could export in a spreadsheet. Or a lot of times, merchandising teams send in requests for their banners that need to be created for their website or app using a spreadsheet-like interface. So it becomes very, very easy for them to just take this spreadsheet, upload it into our product, and then just probably QA it once to make sure everything looks okay. And then your outputs can be pushed to the relevant platforms, right? So I would suggest if you all have any questions, please keep adding them to the chat box and we will catch up with them towards the end, right? Okay, cool. Now, some examples of how teams are using this user interface. So we work with designers again, right? One of the biggest advantages of this for designers is any kind of repetitive work they are doing, especially as they make different types of adapts, different types of sizes, all of that gets taken care of, right? Performance marketing teams, because they don't want to keep going to designers asking them about their their creatives, because they have to push a campaign live, right? So once the designers have set the template, all the performance marketing individual does is they come to this user interface, quickly make their campaigns, create a different version to A/B test, and then push it on these different platforms, right? And lastly, again, a social media team of an e-commerce company, again, is using this for pushing creatives on different social platforms. The advantage for them is that all the creatives for all the social platforms get created all at once, right? Now, with respect to cost savings, I think it's intuitive to know that on the creative production side, right, there is definite cost savings, because just imagine if your existing team can create, like we spoke about, 1500 banners in a minute, then your existing team, just imagine how much more they could do, right? But what is often ignored is just the amount and effort saved in avoiding a lot of coordination and rework, right? Now, we've seen some of our customers actually save up to 75% of their costs just by implementing a self-service solution like this and trying to remove some of the slack in their processes, right? All right, so let's move on. So the next topic we are going to talk about is how we empower external partners, right? So I'm going to do this by using the example of how we work with Amazon, right? So just to give you some context, Amazon has advertisers. These advertisers want to advertise on Amazon.com. Typically, Amazon has an internal team who used to take care of these advertisers, right? So they would make banners. There used to be a lot of back and forth because the advertisers wanted to make sure their creatives look a certain way, but Amazon wanted to make sure that these creatives are compliant and at the end of the day look nice on their platform, right? So because of this, there was a lot of back and forth. It used to take the in-house design team a really long time to get a creative approved, right? So what we did for them is, again, we sat in the middle wherein we tried to reduce the effort for the Amazon team, ensured that there is stricter brand compliance, and created a self-service experience for Amazon advertisers, right? And how we did that is by taking the solution we just spoke about, campaign, and white labeling that entire experience for Amazon, right? So what white labeling essentially means is, again, there's no mention of our logo. It's more branded in our clients' colors and guidelines. But most importantly, the entire journey of how a end user uses this product is configured. So for example, you could say, hey, I will just allow these 20 colors in my banners. I will not allow them to add a logo. I will only allow them to change or move around the different elements. I won't allow any sort of advanced editing, right? So these are very important considerations as you think about building a seamless journey for your vendor or partner, right? So let me try and explain this with a few examples. So there is a fashion marketplace in the UK, right? So what they are doing is every time a user lists a particular product on their platform, they are able to actually help them generate videos that directly go onto the product pages, right? There is a car listing platform. So they enable, so they already had a bunch of users. So they are using, they added our platform as a value addition to their existing capabilities, where now their dealers can actually come in and make brand compliant car ads that can go on these different platforms, right? And finally, a food delivery platform is actually allowing restaurants, which means in this case their partners, to create different kinds of offer banners for their app, right? So you can imagine that the app has to be very clean. There will be only certain ways in which the banner can look, right? So once those templates are set up by this food delivery platform, a user can come in or a restaurant owner can come in, quickly add his or her dishes, and you can now get these images that go on the banner. Go on the app. All right. So with this sort of an experience, definitely we can imagine how there can be efficiencies, because we had spoken about that in our previous section, right? But what you can also add to this is just the cost of or the savings from not having to build this on your own, right? So if food delivery app wanted to build this on their own, there would be a lot of developers, maintenance that you would need to do for the tool. You would need to make sure that it's working properly all the time. Rather than spending all that money, you can take a solution like this, a white label solution. You can embed it into your platform and almost outsource a lot of the design work to your external partners or vendors, right? So that you don't have to have a team that services this, right? You set up the guardrails, and within those guardrails, these vendors and partners can go and make brand compliant creatives that can solve different purposes for your business, right? Beautiful. So the last part that I want to touch upon is how we are actually enabling businesses to create banners and videos without any kind of human intervention, right? So in the first few cases, in the first section, we talked about how business teams, internal teams, are using the interface to create videos and images. In the second section, we spoke about how this is being done by external partners or vendors using the white label solution. In this case, the way to actually pass data to these templates is without any human intervention. We are doing this through our APIs, right? So I'm not going to go very deep into this, given the in the interest of time and also keeping the audience profile in mind. But just know that if you have a database worth of if you have a database which has a lot of structured data, this could be your products, it could be let's say if it's a marketplace, it could be listings. All of these can be converted to videos and images using our APIs to solve very interesting use cases, right? Now, typically, this product works with two use cases, right? One where you have a large amount of inventory, right? So inventory of products, inventory of listings, and you want to convert all of them to videos and images. And the second one is where you want to personalize, right? So imagine you create a nice looking creative. It could be an image or a video, but now you want to personalize it, right? You want to say, hi, Karan, you want to do this for 100,000 customers. You are able to do it using this platform, right? So again, talking about a few examples here. So the most intuitive one you can imagine is product catalog videos, right? If you're an e-commerce company, you have a product page. If that product page needs to have videos and you have 100,000 products, no way you can do that manually, right? So you can do it using the APIs. There is a US-based company who's using this for personalized product offers. So knowing what you've done, what sort of purchases you've made in the past, what sort of pages you've visited, what is your propensity to pay. Based on that, they are able to actually mine information from their database, connect it to ours, and generate creatives and share it with their customers, right? And finally, this is an interesting use case, which is abandoned cart GIFs. So what they're doing is, if, for example, I'm going to purchase a product, but I leave it in my cart, they are able to quickly generate, let's say it's in my cart for half an hour, they generate a GIF which says that, you know what, hey Karan, you're going to buy this washing machine, it's still in your cart, here, take a 10% discount and buy it now, right? And then they send it in an email just to have that personalized communication go out, right? Now, as it comes to cost savings with respect to APIs, right? So as you can imagine, as you increase your human effort, right? Typically the cost per creative keeps going higher because either there are overheads, you need a lot of management, also comes with licenses and equipment that you would need, right? And beyond a certain threshold, it's impossible to even think of manual creation, right? If I wanted to create 100,000 creatives, it's impossible to say that we would be able to do this using manual effort, and practically it would be uneconomical at that scale, right? But if you think about automation, your per creative cost actually keeps going down as your number of creatives increase, right? So beyond a certain threshold, if you want to make creatives, automation becomes your only option and also a more cost effective option, right? All right, cool. So we will go ahead and just summarize the session here. So we spoke about how we enable internal teams. We try and reduce redundant effort by ensuring that our templates take care of a lot of the repurposing and creation of banners or videos. We enable business, we enable non-designers, business users to create this so that we are enabling self-service and the design team is not bogged down with a lot of requests. We spoke about how we empower external partners. We are able to take our existing solution, make it white labeled, and almost outsource the creatives that are made for this business. And finally, we spoke about how we can completely remove human intervention, and using our APIs, we can create videos or images. Typically, this works where you have high amount of inventory or you want to personalize your creatives, right? That's it from my end today. I hope this session was useful. I really, again, appreciate the time that you have taken. I will open this out to questions. We have a few minutes, but I'm here for as much as you need me to answer these questions. So Jadev and Jatin, if you can help me with the questions, that would be really helpful.
Sure, Karan. So we've got a bunch of questions. The first one is, what is the time taken to render images and videos?
Sure. So if you think about images, with respect to images, this happens on a real-time basis, right? Like if you render a creative, it will be ready probably in a second. With respect to videos, it depends on the length of the video. So if, for example, a video is 20 seconds in length, within 30 seconds, it should be ready, right? So it depends on the length, the quality. There are some parameters, but roughly you can say between 1.5 to 2 times the length of the video, it should be ready and rendered.
You got a question from Sachin. He asks, what are the initial inhibitions and challenges to set this up for a team that one should keep in mind?
So I think based on my learnings, I would say that if you're using a product like this, somewhere you want to make sure that you are, you are creating designs and then you are creating outputs from that design at scale, right? Because somewhere if you're using, you're trying to create new designs every time, somewhere this may not work. So that would be one thing that I've learned from working with clients. The other thing is, with clients, what I've noticed is they are somewhere not sure of enabling business users to make these videos and images. But if we are able to set this up, set these templates up nicely, we are able to create a robust, we are able to create robust guardrails and rules around it. it really becomes a very, very seamless experience. I've seen this time and again, right? So somewhere there are inhibitions at first, but once they are able to actually see that outputs look really nice and they align with the firm's brand guidelines, right? I mean, it's a very seamless conversation to have. So I think those would be my two learnings. I hope I've answered the question.
Great. The third question we have is from an agency who is asking, saying that can we push these creatives directly to Google, Facebook, or other social channels?
Yes. So if you are using the user interface that I spoke about, when you export, you're able to push it to, let's say, your YouTube playlist or your Facebook library, etc. If you're doing it through the API route, it's completely automated. So we've integrated with the APIs of all these social channels. So the moment the creative is rendered, it can be pushed to these social channels.
Got it. We have one more question from an agency who is asking that we have only one client asking for videos. So can we use this solution in that case?
So again, I would say it depends on the scale, right? So if the scale is high enough, it makes sense because either you want to automate it or you want to use the APIs. If it is one or two videos, then I don't think it would, at least this solution would not make sense. Wherever there is scale and that we need to create multiple variations, multiple adaptations of videos and images, this would be perfect.
Great. We have a follow-up question from Sachin. He says, if I want to upload a video directly to Amazon details page, how do we do that?
So again, right, today, the way we work with Amazon is that we enable their advertiser and their advertising team, right? So somewhere we don't have a product that we are opening out to our customers that can actually go and upload videos and images to Amazon. So Amazon is our client. We are enabling their advertisers. So with respect to the detail page, we don't have a direct integration today. You can make the video, you can make the image, and then you can upload it when you're listing your product.
Got it. So any questions, please ask them in the chat window. We'll just take about 30 seconds.
Sure.
There's another follow-up question from Sachin who asks, who in your experience makes the final decision for buying such a solution?
So typically, it again depends on the use case, I would say. So if it's like, let's say a performance marketing use case, it would be either the CMO, VP marketing is who would take the call, right? If it is any product level integration, like I told you, let's say you're using our APIs to automatically generate listing videos for your product pages, it would be more on the product side. If it is related to like almost optimizing time for the design team, it would be head of design or head of creatives. That would be the decision maker for us. So it really depends on the use case.
Great. So any other questions, attendees, please ask them in the webinar chat.
Awesome. So my email address is there. So feel free to drop me a line if you have any questions, if you have any insights, or if you have any feedback about this discussion, I would love to hear it and I'll definitely revert. All right. So thank you again for taking the time. Have a great week ahead and a great week.
Karan.
Yes.
I have one more question that's come up right now.
Oh, okay. Cool.
Yeah. So do you have any examples of conversion rate improvements for customers using videos at scale? That is the effectiveness of videos at the scale. This has been asked by Enda.
Again, we've seen this in multiple use cases, right? Especially on the personalization side, where we are actually able to, let's say, send a personalized GIF in an email, or let's say there is a notification in your app that is more personalized, showing more personalized offers. Definitely have seen some of our clients, and I think it was Enda, and I'm happy to discuss this offline in more detail, but on the personalization side, we've definitely seen more conversion. Where it comes to where we've created videos at scale for, let's say, product listings on pages, that has not seen that. In some cases, that's also seen an improvement, but not as much as what we've seen on the on personalizing videos and images.
Great. I think we are done with the Q&A, Karan.
Okay, great. Yeah, I think we went a bit over, didn't we? All right. Thank you so much, everyone, for joining this. Stay in touch. And if you have any questions, do reach out to me. Bye-bye.